want to sit up a little higher and keep your hands out like this for stabilization. Now, the way you steer a shovel, you start to spin like this, which that's the thing. Shovels spin out. They're going to lose control. So if it starts to spin, you drag this hand, and it brings you back in. If you start to spin this way, you drag this hand, brings you back in. What we teach beginners, the worst thing you can do is sit up and hold the shovel, because then you're on this curved part, and you can spin around backwards. This will dig into the snow, and instead of your balls, this will wham right in the head.
Yeah. We actually call that.
But what we tell people is what we have, what we call the safety position. It's the corpse position. If you're losing control on the shovel, the best thing to do is just
lie down,
lay back. And if you're sideways, wherever you're at, it'll just straighten you back out. So if you're like, whoa, you lose control, lay back, and it'll just drag you back to the front, and then you sit back up and you go. But you don't ever hold on to the handle, and you never sit forward. It's luge. If you stay focused, you keep your feet pointed, stay back. You don't want to lean too far back, or your back will drag on the snow. That'll slow you down, so you want to be just like this. And it's an ab workout. You can see I have a speed ab here, my unit ab.
We call it the speed hump.
The speed hump. People say, well, how come the big guys do better on shovel racing? And we're like, well, the wind comes over, catches this, and to stop, there's several different ways. What we do is, you know, we tell some people just go into the corpse, or you can sit up, then you can hold the shovel just as stability, use your feet, but you eat snow really hardcore at those speeds. What I do is I slow down a little, pull the shovel out, and I slide. And just, you know, I mean, you know, in a race like that, but in our world championships, it's just... That's right, see, I'm telling you, the speed ab helps. A lot of people do that. They'll pull up on the handle, but then their shovel's bent and you can't use it again. So,
John, where'd you buy that
stuff? You know, just a regular hardware store. Just a regular hardware store, Ace Hardware in Albuquerque. And the only, now, on a shovel like this, you cannot modify it at all. Some people try to fill in the grooves or try to cut pieces
to make it pound flat.
Those are all illegal. All you can do is decorate the handle, maybe paint something in here.
You can sand, buff it, wax it, whatever you want.
You have to stay stock grain scoop shovel.
Okay. Yes.
Okay, first thing we want to do is get you in the right position on the snow shovel. So go ahead and sit in it. Now you want to scoot back as far as you can without touching the snow. So scoot your butt back a little bit.
Just like this.
Mm-hmm. Now you want to grip the handle with your knees. So put your legs together. There you go. Hold it just like that. Okay.
この部分ですね。これをしっかりと押さえることです。But
okay, you're not going to do that. All right. So what you don't want to do is sit up because you'll start on the thing and you'll start spinning around. You want to lean back like that. Okay. So first thing, put your hands to your side just like that. So what you're going to do is you're going to be going like this so your hands are like stabilizers, helping you stay straight. Okay?
It's just the muscle, right?
Yeah, it's the muscle. Okay. So then what happens is, let's say you start to spin this way.
Right.
You want to drag that hand harder on the ground,
right,
and that'll bring you around this way. Now, if you start to spin this way, you drag this hand on the ground, okay, and it'll bring you around. Whoa, hold on. Push your feet in. If you start to lose control,
right,
don't sit up and grab the handle. Uh-huh. Lean all the way back, all the way. So you're touching the snow. So
just let the shovel away. Let the shovel
No, leave
away.
The shovel there, but you just want to lay all the way back until you feel like you're in control, then sit back up and you'll just keep going.
Right.
Okay?
Okay.
Dead body position, exactly.
Okay. So if we turn around this way, we just use this hand, right?
If you start to spin this way, you touch that hand.
That hand.
Because it'll bring you, you're going to touch the hand you want to go back the way you want.
Okay.
So if you want this, if you're this way, if the sled's that way, your shovel's that way, you drag this hand because it'll bring you back to that side.
Okay.
But if you really start to spin, corpse, and it'll drag you right back to the fall line.
Okay.
Okay? Pure shovel. It's just me and this right here.
Standard production.
72 miles an hour on this shovel.
They come in different sizes. I mean, this is an aluminum shovel, but they also have steel shovels, which are much heavier and a little more durable. And depending on the conditions, I might choose a steel or I might choose the aluminum. But I have about four shovels, but the thing with the aluminums is they bend easily. So if you have a good wipeout, you might bend the shovel, then that's it. It's a disposable. You got to buy a new one. You know, you can get them anywhere. I mean, the shovels are the same no matter where you go. I mean, as long as you get a grain scoop
shovel.
But I mean, you can go down to Home Depot, you can go to your local, you know, gardening shop. I mean, you know, most places carry them. So I mean, you know, there's not a special place. I mean, I go, when I'm shopping for a shovel, I'll go to many different places and I'll look at every single one. And I'll look at them, make sure they're straight and there's no dents and that it's perfect. And if it's not perfect, I'm not buying it. So this one right here, I probably went to 4 different shops until I found it, because it was perfect. Because sometimes they come right off the rack and they're a little bent, and you can't ride a bent shovel, so you gotta get that perfect shovel. And this one used to be perfect, but after that big crash up there today, it's a little bent now. You wanna be in one that fits you, because if it cups you in, that way you don't slide around. If you're riding in a big 14, you have more potential of sliding up on the shovel and losing control. So you want a shovel that fits. And that's why you get it, you sit in it, you know, you wiggle your butt, you kind of check, and you feel it out, and you make sure it fits you. You know, I mean, that's the thing. You can't put anything on the inside. Like, some people have shown up and tried to put Velcro here and different things to hold their butts in the shovel, but that's a modification. You cannot do that. Disqualified. You cannot put anything in here to hold you in the shovel, because the whole point is you've got to be able to hold yourself in the shovel. You can't have something attaching you to the shovel. So you can't put Velcro on and hold on, or put like a sticky surface or sandpaper here to hold you in, you know? It's gotta look just like, you can paint it if you want, decorate it, but that's not gonna hold you in, that's not gonna keep you in the shovel. Any modification to the shovel that helps it either go fast or helps you in it, any of those things, absolutely illegal.
That's fun.
Yeah,
it's
good. If you practice a little bit, you'd be in there.
And then it's all just a matter of wax.
Ready.
Let's see it.
Yeah, I was like, the sled. But I mean, that's like really low speed for what we normally do. I mean,
How fast was that?
That was maybe 25. I mean, that very slow. I mean, I'd like to go to the very top of that jump and just burn, but you know, the ski area is open, so of course, I mean, they ice our course down, because of the harder, the faster.
I think he's better than you are.
Well, he's won twice.
Rock and roll.